What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're getting into mid-December here, and a lot of people like to do this, and that's like they like to bait deer, per se, corn, whatever it is that they use, to try to attract them, to check inventory on what deer has made it through the year. And it's a good practice to do, but you have to be careful with it. There's other methods, you know, you could do it as well. You know, if you have a food plot, an unpressured food plot, the deer are still going to be hitting that in the afternoon, and you can check inventory there. You can check travel corridors to and from bedding with trail cameras. It's going to give you inventory. But the easiest way, really, is to put corn out, and that's what majority of hunters do, is they dump some corn or spread some corn out, and you can get pictures up close and personal of some inventory bucks that you have left over to where you could possibly hunt them next year. The problem with this is a lot of times, you know, we do more harm than good when we do this. Most people, and I've made videos about this in the past, and they've done very well on YouTube, 30, 40, 50, 60,000 views on them from last year, but it's dumping corn in a pile, especially in areas that don't have a lot of agricultural around cornfields, to where deer aren't used to eating corn. When you introduce corn into a deer's diet out of nowhere, it can kill them. There's many research studies on this. It happens. I've seen it happen. You can make the deer very sick. And there's a way around that, and it's pretty simple. Is no matter if you're putting corn out to bait deer to hunt them, or you're just putting corn out to check inventory, it's the same practice. I use the same method over and over and over with good results. If I was putting corn out to bait a deer to, say, bow hunt over it or something, I'm taking that corn and I'm spreading it out, okay, in the woods. When you spread corn out, instead of dumping it in a pile, you make the deer search for it. You know, when you sling corn out of a 50-pound bag, whatever it is, you're slinging that corn, those kernels are landing underneath the leaves, underneath the branches, to where the deer come in. Yeah, they can see some, you know, corn there, and they start milling around eating it, but it's under the leaves. You have to make that deer work for it. When you make the deer work for it, it's more natural. It's like they're walking through the woods eating acorns that fallen out of the tree. Those acorns are landing underneath the leaves, underneath the trees, underneath the branches, to where you have to make that deer work to eat those acorns. It's the same for corn. You're making that deer search and work for that corn, to where they have to move around. You know, they're getting a bite here, bite here, bite there. When you're dumping in a pile, okay, a giant corn pile, you just take that bag and you dump it on the ground, that corn's exposed, fully exposed, and the deer can sit there and consume gulps of it, mouthfuls of that corn, and that can kill them. They sit there, they overeat the corn because it's right there, they don't have to work for it, deer are lazy, and they will consume that corn in large quantities, and you can possibly kill that deer. If you just take the extra couple minutes, doesn't take long, take the extra couple minutes, spread that corn out over whatever it is, 20, 30, 40, 50 yard span in the woods, whether it's in a field, you know, in the woods where you have a bunch of debris and stuff, just sling it, you know, just hold that bag, scoop your hand in there, just sling it out, just walk and sling it, whether you're baiting deer to hunt them or you're just checking inventory. It's a great practice. It's a safe practice to do. Even then, you don't want to, you know, take 10 bags of corn and sling it all at once. Introduce it slowly, especially if you haven't been doing it throughout the year. If you're just doing it all of a sudden, you know, take a 50-pound bag, one bag, sling it out, wait a week or something, you know, 10 days, 7 days, whatever it is, come back in, sling another bag, sling two bags, introduce it slowly, but no matter what you do, sling it. Do not dump it in a pile. Also, when you dump it in a pile, you encourage that corn to sit there and rot and mold, and it stinks, you know, and you get bugs in there, and it's just not natural to have that, you know, corn mold over. If you sling it out, it's more natural. Make the deer work for it. You guys will have good success with it. Let me know in the comments below if you've done this. I've been getting these comments recently from people doing it this past year from the videos that I made last year, and they're applying the practice this year. You know, it's nothing, it's no secret, you know, people have been doing this, but a lot of hunters, you know, we just get that in our mind, we just dump it out, and it makes it easier. Take the time, sling it out, comment down below if you've done this year and had good results with it. You make the deer, it's more natural for them, they get less skittish around it, and it'll work. Let me know in the comments below.